In this video, I will show how to simulate tomographic X-ray measurements in the form of a sinogram, and then reconstruct the image using filtered back projection. Also, we will take a look at the effects of measurement noise and see how to deal with that. Welcome to the fourth lecture in my online course on tomography. Let's try out tomographic reconstruction in MATLAB, my favorite software. I know that not all of you have access to MATLAB, so I will put links to openly available programming options to the video description down there. With them, you can try these things out for yourself for free. First, I read into MATLAB a simple digital phantom I created. There are two disks of constant X-ray attenuation equal to 1 in an empty background of 0 attenuation. The MATLAB command radon simulates parallel beam tomographic measurements of the phantom along the angles of projection we choose. I will go with densely sampled full angle data, going from 0 degrees to 360 degrees in half degree steps. The result is called a sinogram. Can you guess where that name comes from? Before continuing to the reconstruction, let's see how the sinogram is formed. Let's back up a little bit. Note that I have marked the start and end of the detector line. Now I turn our measurement device 180 degrees. You see that here the projection of the bigger disk is on top in the sinogram because the detector has turned around. It's a simple thing, but very confusing. Now it's time to reconstruct our digital phantom. Filtered back projection can be done in MATLAB using the iRadon command, standing for inverse radon transform. We give iRadon the sinogram and the measurement angles as arguments. Also, we add the number of rows in our phantom so that the output of iRadon has the correct size. The resulting picture looks exactly like the original phantom, just as it should. Since I'm explaining this in video form, I want to show the reconstruction process in a more fancy way, building up with the rotation. Isn't it sweet? Let me note that we can also choose option None for the filter in the iRadon command. This produces unfiltered back projection that we have already seen in previous videos. Okay, we got a pretty much perfect reconstruction result above with filtered back projection. But in practical measurements, the data will be noisy. We can simulate that by adding random numbers to the sinogram. The quality of the sinogram is now much worse than before. What happens when we reconstruct from such noisy data? So we get a quite noisy result, which is not surprising. One way to reduce the effect of noise is modifying the filter in FBP. We can add another argument to iRadon, setting frequency content to 0 above the specified cutoff frequency. The frequency-limited reconstruction is not noisy anymore, but it is a bit blurred, which is a natural consequence of the low-pass filter we applied. Now it's a good time to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching and look out for the next videos.